Sending gratitude to Anchor FM, where Through Inspired Eyes is recorded. If you haven't heard of Anchor, it is the easiest way to make a podcast. First of all, it's free. Pretty great for a solopreneur. There are creation tools that allow you to record and edit your podcast right from your phone or computer. Stress-free. Anchor will distribute the podcast for you so it can be heard on Spotify, Apple, and then some. We love amplifying. You can make money from your podcast with no minimum listenership. So it's everything you need to make a podcast in one place. Download the Anchor app for free or go to anchor.fm to get started. Hi, everyone. Welcome to Through Inspired Eyes. In today's episode, I speak with Dina Farmer, owner of Lily Magnolia Travel and the host of the Autism Travel podcast. I met Dina through social media and realized I had to know her better. It started with her posts about autism travel, and then I learned about her podcast. At the time, it was called the Special Needs Travel Podcast. I was fascinated by the topics. They ranged from traveling while pregnant to traveling with endometriosis. I realized that I had so much to learn, and Dina was providing this incredible resource for that. You know how I always say, trust the travel experts? Well, Dina is a phenomenal example of a travel advisor that relieves stress. As a mom of an autistic child, she has made travel a priority for her family and done the research so others with autism don't have to. Since our talk, she is fully focused on communicating about autism travel as it best serves her clients. Plus, there's so much to learn. By using her voice, Dina is doing the work for more inclusive travel. She's an inspiration and I celebrate her. Dina's contact information is in the show notes. I know she would appreciate some love from those who heard her here today. Thank you for listening today and always. If you enjoy the podcast, please follow, leave a review, and share on social media. You can tag me on Instagram at Inspired Journey Consulting, and I'll reshare with gratitude. Are you looking for ways to be a better you every day? Has travel assisted your healing journey? I'm Jackie Roby, Chief Excellence Officer of Inspired Journey Consulting and your host for Through Inspired Eyes. Travel is one of the tools I use to overcome trauma. As a sales strategist and diversity, equity, inclusion advocate, I work with healing travel businesses to amplify their voices. It is my mission to grow emotional intelligence, promote healing, and ultimately create a kinder, more inclusive world. I'm grateful to have you here. Hello, Jackie Roby, Chief Excellence Officer of Inspired Journey Consulting. Today, I'm incredibly grateful to be talking to Dina Farmer. Dina is the owner of Lily and Magnolia Travel and the host of the Special Needs Travel Podcast and a mother of two. How many hats can this woman wear? Welcome, Dina.
Thank you. Oh, Jackie, thank you for having me. I guess a lot of hats. Don't we all as mothers wear tons of hats?
And one of the things, I hope you don't mind me sharing, but I love that you're recording from your car because I think that is so true to form with what life is and the reality that we face.
I mean, it's true. And if you follow me on social media at all, like 90% of all my content is done right here in this vehicle. Even my podcast and like booking clients trips are all done. Like I don't live in my car, but I spend a lot of time in it.
The place of quiet.
Right.
Yeah. The place of quiet.
Yeah. Maybe I would spend, if the pandemic wasn't here, then 90% of my day would probably be in my son's therapy clinic with my headphones on, but just the car or the clinic, one of the two. That's where I spend so much.
The beauty of working remotely.
Yeah. Yes. Yes. Thank goodness for that. Because I don't know what I would do if I have to be in a brick and mortar building with all the therapies that I have to take my son to.
So this is a perfect place to start. Tell us about you, your journey, and what Lily and Magnolia Travel is all about.
Sure. So I am a travel advisor, and I originally started in Disney, and I really loved Disney because it's like a place where you can, you know, be a child while still being physically an adult. But when my son was diagnosed with autism in 2019, I decided that it'd be really good for me to pivot my business because I was struggling as the mother of a child with autism to travel the world. And since I was struggling, there must be other people out there that are struggling too. So I decided right then and there after a trip to Turkey by myself with my two little boys that that was the end of it. Like, absolutely, I would love to help other people, but my focus is helping families, particularly with autism, but other disabilities as well. So it's a really passion project of mine because this is a severely underserved community. And I feel like we're getting there in the travel and tourism industry, but we're not there yet. And we have awareness, but now we need to take that awareness to training and acceptance and more programs beyond just what the ADA says.
100%. I mean, this is part of having an inclusive world, inclusive travel, inclusive wellness. So I love that you're doing that. And thank you for what you bring to the world.
Thank you, Jackie. Thank you.
So can you tell us, what are some of the key questions that you ask suppliers?
So to be transparent, I mostly work with families with children, school age children. So the biggest question I always ask is, if there is a kids club, does the staff at the kids club have specialty training, particularly with autism or other disabilities? And if they don't, are they willing to make exceptions for my family? So for example, if the older child has autism and he or she has a sibling, I'll ask if the sibling is allowed to be in the older level with that child so that they don't feel alone, because that's something with autism, is that routine is key and strangers are not so great. So being able to have that sibling with them, regardless of the sibling's age, really helps make a successful vacation. And then I ask if they are willing to make accommodations, such as having like door alarms for children that elope, or having something simple like making sure that there's a lifeguard on hand, because lots of autistic individuals love the water, but they may not necessarily know water safety. So making sure that there is a lifeguard, regardless of cruise or hotel, because that's super important. And I know that there's some cruise lines that don't have lifeguards. And in that case, I wouldn't recommend that my client cruise with them because of the safety issue in that. And then the last thing is meals. That's my like very last thing, is because I know from my son personally, he's a very, very picky eater. So if the chef cannot make accommodations, so for example, he is a pescatarian, so he won't touch meat with a 5-foot pole. Forget about it. So like, there needs to be something that he can eat there, or we can't go. Like, I can't let my child go hungry. So there's some, like, as long as the chef can accommodate for my family or other families. So those are my top three things that I always ask suppliers, make sure that it can work for my client or myself.
And that's so huge. And these are the things that you wouldn't normally think to look for, that mm-hmm. you can't find on an internet search, that you could spend hours having to do, which is part of the beauty of working with you, the incredibly experienced and helpful travel advisor.
Thank you.
I have a love for travel advisors in the first place. And I just think using one helps to decrease your stress. And I imagine as a caregiver, it's just an extra added bonus.
Right. And I feel like when you don't have to worry about that, when that barrier of stress is removed from having to worry about like, what foods can they eat? Will they have a weighted blanket at the hotel? Do they have safety involved? Is it possible to have private transfers just in case their child is already overstimulated from the airport? Like things like that. Like if you could just take all of that and just wash it away, I feel like that makes it that much easier to get out on the road. And then to have somebody that actually gets it, like what it's like to have a child that is also on the spectrum or has a disability, that makes it, I mean, I'm not saying I'm better than somebody that, you know, gets the training by any means, but I just get it. Like I can sympathize with them and not.
Absolutely. Like,
yeah.
I mean, one of the things that makes you, you and is a special relationship that you have with your clients.
Right. Right. Exactly. So
because it's all about relationships.
110%. And I feel like that is the most important part, is being able to articulate that and get it.
Hey there, inspired travelers. I'm interrupting this program for a brief commercial break. Question: does selling make you feel uncomfortable? And have all the pandemic restrictions made you weary of talking about your wellness or healing travel business? I am so excited to share that Inspired Journey Consulting now has one-on-one coaching services to help ease the stress and teach you 4 key tips to direct pent-up travel demand to ultimately increase your revenue. As a sales strategist and social media amplifier, I help my clients set achievable goals to effectively impact their bottom line. Work with Inspired Journey Consulting to develop authentic messaging, get insight from an experienced sales professional, and drive revenue to your wellness travel business. Visit inspiredjourneyconsulting.com and look for Coaching with Care under the services menu. Schedule a complimentary consultation call today. Looking forward to connecting.
So the Special Needs Travel Podcast, mm-hmm. I love, I know it's kind of new. I am so obsessed with it. In the episodes that you've done so far and the people that you've met and connected with, what are some things that you've learned or that have inspired you?
You know, I think the one episode in particular with Al Cole about sickle cell disease, I had, like, you learn about it in health class, but I had no idea the thought process and how difficult it can be to travel with sickle cell disease. And like, I'm learning so much. Like, I didn't think about things like how oxygen can be tricky, because if you're flying in the air, like, you know, your blood needs oxygen. And when you have sickle cell, that affects your iron. I didn't know about that, but I've been learning about that. And the episode about traveling while blind, there was so much with that I didn't know. So I feel like through this journey with the Special Needs Travel Podcast, I'm learning a wealth of things that I would have never come across if I had just stayed in the autism arena, which it's such a fortunate, and I don't know how to say this any other way, but it's just such a blessing that all these people have said yes to coming on my podcast and being really raw and honest with me and just sharing how difficult some of their travel journeys have been, but working with the right travel advisor or even being the travel advisor themselves has really helped shape their travels, which I hope that somebody is listening from the travel industry that could be like, oh, these people are asking for these things, so maybe we should start looking at this in the future, you know?
Absolutely. Because it's, you know, it's not about looking at the majority, right? Right. Because what is the majority anyway?
Right. That's true.
So... whole other topic, Dina. I know.
It's true. You're right, Jack.
So tell us, what do you do for self-care?
Oh my gosh. I did talk about it a little bit with Cabrina on the podcast, and I get up super duper early in the morning at like 5 o'clock in the morning. And my big self-care is reading, you know, some not so great guilty pleasure stuff on the internet and drinking a full cup of hot coffee. Like, I feel like if I can just have that one, like, whole cup of hot coffee, my world is made. And it's just like, and it's quiet. There's nobody asking me to do anything. The TV's not on. It's just, I think that's what it is. It's like, because, you know, my day is filled with appointments and therapies and the 3-year-old and feeding and cooking and cleaning and working with my clients. It's like, there's never a moment in my day where it's very quiet, except for that time at like 5 o'clock in the morning where it's just super quiet, except sometimes, you know, to be transparent, I live on an Air Force base and sometimes they fly super early in the morning. But other than that, like there's a plane flying over my house right now. And it's just, I feel like that quiet and that time is really when I get to reflect and get back to myself and like who I am and really giving back to Dina instead of Dina the mom, Dina the travel advisor, Dina the podcast host and all this other stuff. So it's like, okay, now I can get on with my day, you know?
Dina the superwoman needs a break.
I'm so busy.
I love that because, you know, you're sitting and you're taking this time with intention. And there's something so beautiful for that to restore your energy. Hearing the planes take off, travel dreaming. Are you doing it? What are you thinking of?
Yes, I really it's not a running joke, but I say it over and over again. I'm 3 years from 40, and I keep saying, like, I want to go to Iceland when I turn 40, but I feel like as soon as this world unlocks, like, I don't know if I want to wait that long and just hop on a plane with my boys and go to Iceland, because it's been, which is funny because I love tropical islands and warm places, but I've always wanted to go and see Iceland. So that's like the top of my list. So like the first place that I can go to when I can leave is, I would love it to be Iceland.
I hear that would be epic.
Yeah. And it, you know, it kind of fuels like my son's wanderlust too, because he loves volcanoes, and I know there's lots of volcanoes there in Iceland, or it's a volcanic island. So both of us are winning, you know. Right.
So Dina, tell everyone where they can find you.
Of course. You can find me on Instagram and Facebook at Lillian Magnolia Travel. And then my website is www.lillianmagnoliatravel.com. And you can find me on all the major podcasting networks at the Special Needs Travel Podcast.
Thank you so much. And for those of you that are subscribing or would like to subscribe to the Inspired Journey Consulting newsletter, and I'll make sure to have all of those links and notes that I'll send out as well. So thank you again. I'm so grateful for you. And everybody follow Dina and listen to the Special Needs Travel Podcast, because you're going to be blown away and addicted.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you for joining Through Inspired Eyes. Don't forget to subscribe to this podcast and join the Travel Can Heal Challenge. Go to inspiredjourneyconsulting.com/travelcanheal to learn more. Until next time, stay inspired.